That's what they're going to have to do. So Hartley will come over the timeline. They have Hartley at the point, and Bell more or less a two now. He hasn't handled the ball that much, and Carroll has done a wonderful job on him. I'll say that. Hartley with it outside to Bell, who works to Walls, who comes in the lane, gets it back to Hartley, who drives to the right side, runs, jumps, and misses. And Ryan Humphrey gets another rebound. Humphrey's been terrific defensively. 39-34. Boston College leads Notre Dame's first possession of the second half. Inglesby drives left to Humphrey in the lane, falling away, missing. And the rebound is grabbed by, Notre Dame didn't get a real good shot. Boston College got it out of there. Harley stops, turns, looks for help, comes inside, driving, jumping block, grabbed by Murphy, another block by Humphrey. As Harley tried to shoot over the trees, comes to Humphrey on the right side, bounces into Swanigan, comes in for the layup. He got it, he fouled. Nice reverse layup. 18 there again, another big play on the defensive end by Humphrey on the block on that side. And a three-point play by Swanigan as he hits it. It's 39-37, a two-point game now. Well, that's the way to start from the second half. It gives the crowd an opening to get back in the game. Yeah, they haven't been in the game the last couple of games. Here's Harley with it outside. Singletary alone and misses. And the rebound, though, comes to Boston College. Harley lays it up now. And Inglesby goes in to get the rebound. Inglesby drives down the lane, lays it underneath to Humphrey. Stuck it, and he's fouled. Great pass by Inglesby. Ties the game at 39. A terrific job by Inglesby on the rebound on the other side. Well, you got in there with the trees and took it away. Free throw is no good. The rebound comes out to Carroll. Gets it to Humphrey. Back to Carroll. Three on the way. Got it. Well, that's a good way to start. An 8-0 run.
Oh, man.
In a minute. Troy struggling. Martin got the rebound because Troy was on the floor at the other end and had taken a couple of guys with him. All right, with him outside now. Boston College on the left side to Singletary. Singletary. Back to Bell. Bell guarded by Carroll. On the left side, Singletary drives in the lane. And Inglesby steals the ball. Drives to the forecourt. Keeps coming. Lays it up. No good. And out of bounds off of Notre Dame.
And it was blocked by Bell. Bell is just a terrific player on both ends of the floor.
42-39. It's Notre Dame leading by three. And here comes Boston College with the ball back now. Bell comes over the timeline. Bell, guarded by Carroll, gets it outside to Harley. On for the running jump shot by Walls. No, whistle. Foul away from the ball against Boston College. Looks like Singletary might have picked it up.
No, it's on Bell. That's his third. That's huge.
You know why, Jack? Carroll's frustrating him with his great defensive play. It's 39-42, Notre Dame by three on the Swanigan. Can't get it. Now Inglesby can't shoot out there. Ball comes through Carroll's hands. Works the ball right side to Humphrey. Inside to Murphy. In the lane. Running. Shooting. Missing. Tipped up. No. Humphrey! No! Whistle. Foul.
And Hump got hammered. Landed on his hands and knees.
He's been outstanding on the backboard.
He is, however, 0-for-2 from the line so far.
Not his strong point. He's 0-for-3. He just has a lot of trouble getting the ball there. It usually hits the front of the rim. So he missed again, and he's 0-for-3. He's up there now, and that's going to be way short. Ball comes out to Carroll. Three on the way. In and out. Humphrey rebounds knocked out of his hands. Oh, man, what a great rebound by Humphrey. That's smart to tip the ball out like that. That's what the other guy's been doing to Notre Dame. Oh, man, that ball by Carroll around the rim and out. But Notre Dame gets the ball, so no big deal. Yeah, they got the ball back. Comes outside to Humphrey. On it comes to Carroll. Works into Swanigan, double team. Now, right side Carroll on the Humphrey on the right corner. Across the court to Inglesby. Carroll, three on the way. Connects! 45-39, Notre Dame leads by six, and Carroll has been terrific.
He leads all scorers with 15 points.
With on the outside is Bell.
Bell drives the left side, on the dribble, stops, shoots. In and out. Rebound chased down by Troy Murphy. Notre Dame with the ball leading by six. Long lead pass to Humphrey. Turns, spins, leads it back. Murphy will try a three. No. Yes! Ball's swinging out and back down again. 48-39 in the fans. Oh, man, they really like that.
Notre Dame has outscored BC 17-0.
Not a bad look for Inglesby there. Had a pretty good look at it. Out of bounds, Notre Dame with it. Inside, whistle, holding call. Is this going to send Humphrey to the line or Murphy?
Murph's going to the line.
Murph's on Ross. That's his fifth, so he's done for the night.
Well, so I had that little time out here.
As long as they got Bell and Harley and Singletary in there,
Sydney,
those are the guys that are offensively Murphy misses.
He's missed two in a row now, if I remember correctly. He's 12 of 17 in the game, which is a very decent performance. But folks, one of the things where fatigue really shows up is in free throws.
1:28 to go in the game, they become bigger.
Oh, they're huge. Yeah. They're huge. But this is also when you battled like Troy, your arms feel like lead right now, and that can have an impact.
He made one out of two. 75-74, Boston College leads at 1:28 to go in the game. From over the timeline with it to BC. On the dribble left side, Notre Dame is man-to-man. Bell wants to go one-on-one here. Now they switch and Swanigan is on. 60 on the shot clock, 108 to go in the game. Bell holds up his left fist. We know he wants it. He drives and leaves it over for Sydney's three. Short. Rebound by Boston College. Eight. Rebound by DC. 75-74. That was maybe the biggest rebound of the game. 47 seconds left in the game. 22 on the shot clock. So the second chance may be the big one here. Unless Notre Dame can come up with a stop. 15 on the shot clock. 35 seconds to go in the game. DC by one. Leaves it over to Harley. Harley fakes. Runs in the lane. Shoots it. Missed it. Rebound Notre Dame. And Carroll comes out there with it. With 25 seconds to go. What are you going to do here?
Mike Gray's going to call a timeout.
75-74, Boston College leads by one. We'll set it up here with 21 seconds to play in the game. And Notre Dame has the ball with a shot clock off.
Been a honey of the game.
Great college basketball game. Dolphins out to Carroll. Carroll has him in the backcourt. He'll come over the timeline. He is guarded by Sydney.
50.
Hands the ball back to Inglesby. Gets it back to Carroll. Now on to Inglesby. On the Graves. They're going to go for the last shot, aren't they?
Five.
Inglesby shoots it. Hits it. Hits it on the run at 3.7 seconds. How do you make that shot? In the lane, off balance.
A runner in the lane.
Game's not over, Jack.
It's not over, but...
It's not over.
Much better shape.
Boston College gets a shot, and if it goes in. That's the nature of college basketball as the month of March approaches. But how many games like this do you see in the NCAA tournament?
About three a day.
Yeah.
Notre Dame has eight fouls, so if they foul in a non-shooting situation, BC will have a 1-1.
With a one-point lead, they don't want to foul here. Singletary. Bounces to Bell. Bell comes over the...
Knocked out of his head! Graves reached from behind, and here come the Stoop on the floor. Wow, what a win for Notre Dame. And what a play. How ironic is that David Graves knocks the ball from behind into the hands of Inglesby. They never got the shot off. The last shot went in, and Notre Dame won the game.